In this lesson, we will determine the measure of a missing angle from a diagram, and then classify the angle as acute, obtuse, or right. For A, we're asked to find the measure of angle 1. Here's angle 1, formed by ray LW and ray LV. We're also given the measure of the larger angle, angle SLV, equals 135 degrees, and also the measure of this angle, angle SLW, equals 88 degrees. So the sum of the measures of these two angles is equal to 135 degrees, and therefore the measure of angle 1 must equal 135 degrees minus 88 degrees. Again, the measure of the large angle minus the measure of this angle must leave us with the measure of angle 1. So the measure of angle 1 must equal 135 degrees minus 88 degrees, which equals 47 degrees. So the measure of angle 1 equals 47 degrees. For B, we're asked to find the measure of angle 2. Angle 2 is this angle here, formed by ray XH and ray XE. Notice how we're given the measure of angle HXG as 113 degrees. And we're also given the measure of angle EXG, this angle here, which measures 21 degrees. From the diagram, notice the measure of angle 2 plus 21 degrees must equal 113 degrees, and therefore the measure of angle 2 must equal 113 degrees minus 21 degrees. So the measure of angle 2 equals 113 degrees, the measure of the large angle, minus the measure of the small angle, which again will leave us with the measure of angle 2. 113 degrees minus 21 degrees equals 92 degrees. The measure of angle 2 equals 92 degrees. Now for part C, we're asked to classify angle 1 and angle 2 as acute, obtuse, or right. The measure of angle 1 is 47 degrees. Because 47 degrees is between 0 degrees and 90 degrees, or greater than 0 degrees and less than 90 degrees, angle 1 is an acute angle. Angle 2 measures 92 degrees. 92 degrees is between 90 degrees and 180 degrees, or 92 degrees is greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees, and therefore angle 2 is an obtuse angle. I hope you found this helpful.